What is up, weather enthusiasts? I'm your host, Pat's Path Predictor. Let's get right into the weather. All right, so here's the situation we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. As one invest in area of interest dies, another one rises from the ashes. That's right. I'm talking about the new area of interest in the Caribbean Sea, and we also have Invest 96L, which now has a very good chance of development as it has been showing signs of organization in the past day or so. Here's what we have going on, according to the National Hurricane Center as well. Here's what we have with Invest 96L. Showers and thunderstorms associated with an area of low pressure located a couple hundred miles east of the southeastern Bahamas continues to show signs of organization. A short-lived tropical depression or storm is likely to form later tomorrow or tonight while the system moves west to northwest, west-northwestward. By Tuesday, however, strong upper level and dry air winds and dry air should end the chances of further development. An Air Force reconnaissance aircraft is scheduled to investigate the storm later today. 70% chance of formation in the next 48 hours and 7 days. Actually, we have a new update for you right now, actually. We have the 2 p.m. advisory as of from the NHC. An Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is currently investigating a broad area of low pressure located a couple hundred miles east of the central Bahamas. Early indications from the plane satellite data show that the system does not have a well-defined surface circulation. Environmental conditions are becoming less conducive for the development, though a short-lived tropical depression or storm could still form in the next day or so. By Tuesday, stronger upper-level winds and dry air should end any chances of further development as it turns northward. 60% chance of formation in the next 48 hours. 60% chance of formation in the next 7 days. So this is definitely something we need to keep a close eye on as time continues to progress, because even though this thing may not develop, it still could bring some impacts towards the Bahamas, maybe towards a couple of other areas like Hispaniola and Haiti, especially because they do not need any more rain than they need to. There's a bunch of mountainous terrain, and that could end up making things a lot worse for them due to mudslides and all that. So that's definitely something we need to pay attention to as of right now. In the meantime, we have this area of interest because previously, we go ahead and show you what happened earlier, around 8 p.m., the latest, the new AOI that was in the Caribbean Sea, it kind of died off. And then just this morning, we started seeing another area of interest being tagged by the NHC. This thing is not over until it's over. So here's what we have going on. A broad area of low pressure could form in a few days over the central or southwestern Caribbean Sea. Gradual development thereafter is possible while the system moves generally westward at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Formation chance is zero in the next 48 hours, but it is at 20% in the next 7 days. And based off of what I've been seeing from some modeling, as well as a bunch of the conditions that I've been noting, this thing does have a really good chance of organizing and developing in the long term. So this is something that we need to pay attention to as time continues to go on, especially since this is in the Caribbean Sea, and this poses a major threat to a lot of people, particularly in Central America, maybe in Cuba, potentially Florida in the long term. But we'll have to pay attention to it as time continues to progress. If we go ahead and next show you the Eastern Pacific situations, we now have Tropical Depression 19E that is organizing and developing out here off the coast of Guatemala. Currently, maximum sustained winds are at 35 miles per hour. Minimum central pressure is 1,005 millibars. Its current location is 11 degrees north, 92.8 degrees west, and it is moving north-northeast at 2 miles per hour. So here's the cone forecast as of right now. It is forecasted to strengthen into a tropical storm and then turn out completely to sea and move at an extremely fast pace. I'd say this is going at like, what, 30 miles per hour at least. So that's pretty interesting to say at the very least. If we go ahead and show you the public advisory, not too much of note is going on. The system is forecasted to begin moving northeastward or east-northeastward tonight, and it could be near the coast of El Salvador or Guatemala on Tuesday night. So if you're tuning in from those areas right there. And we do have Spanish subtitles for you guys. You guys need to be paying attention to this because this could be a potential threat, especially with rainfall and maybe some gusty winds. I know Central America is very mountainous too, so my main concern is mudslides that could potentially impact those countries as well. If we go ahead and show you the discussion as of right here, there hasn't been a lot of net movement with the system, with perhaps a slight north-northeastern motion recently. The system should begin to move northeastward or east-northeastward at a slow pace later today as it becomes steered by flow in association with a mid to upper level trough over the northeastern Caribbean. If the low-level center can continue consolidating, then some slow strengthening could happen later today. More significant intensification is possible Monday, assuming a central core can develop, with almost all guidance showing that the system can be near hurricane strength on Tuesday. After that, strong vertical wind shear, possible land interaction, and intrusions of dry air and stable air will likely cause a weakening trend. And here's the kicker right here. In the next Next 48 hours, it's forecasted to get up to a 70-mile-per-hour tropical storm. There's definitely some really good conditions it's under right now. So if it takes full advantage of this, well, we could see a potentially stronger system than just 70 miles per hour as this approaches Guatemala and El Salvador. So we will have to pay attention to this as time continues to go on and as this poses a greater threat to land in the coming days. So here's the cone. It gets close to El Salvador and Guatemala and potentially bring some heavy rainfall over there. Definitely something to pay attention to. And the big question is how quickly can this get over? Because the quicker the motion of this system is, the more likely of an impact you see in El Salvador especially. So that's what we have going on in the Eastern Pacific Ocean at this current point in time. Now we're going to go ahead and show you some of the conditions that we're looking at, because you're probably saying at this point, Patrick, you're talking about all these invests, you're talking about everything that's going on the map from the NHC, but you're not talking about the conditions. What are the conditions going on? Well, here's the conditions I am noticing. First of all, where the AOI is near the, in the Caribbean Sea, it's over global sea temperatures of well over 30 degrees Celsius or 86 degrees Fahrenheit for those of you who live in the United States and Puerto Rico. And based off of these sea surface temperatures alone, this is more than enough for organization and development at a very fast pace, especially in this part of the world where we're still seeing very record global sea temperatures. And I'm hoping at this point that this thing, as much as I hate to say it, does develop, because right now the Caribbean Sea is untapped. And my concern is, let's say it remains untapped throughout the winter and it cools down only down to like 27, 26 degrees Celsius or about 80 to 82 degrees Fahrenheit. No, that's actually 78 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. That's my concern. And then when we come springtime, the stuff starts warming up again and we start seeing much higher ocean heat content values. So that's my main concern if this remains untapped. But in the meantime, we are looking at these great conditions in the Caribbean Sea, and also we have a huge amount of ocean heat content that is still virtually unused. And where this area of interest is in right now, it's in an area of consistently over 125 ocean heat content, which for those of you who do not know how much OHC that is, well, to put that in perspective, 100 OHC is very favorable for rapid intensification under the right conditions. 125 is good, is even better than that, good for very fast, potentially explosive intensification if all the conditions are just perfect. Anything higher than that, yeah, that's going to potentially be a big situation if the right conditions start to manifest. So that's what we have with the ocean heat content, especially in the Caribbean. And going again, my main concern is throughout the winter, this remains untapped. And then in the spring, we start seeing much higher values than we did in 2024 because of such untapped conditions. So that's what we have going on with the OHC. Now, if we go ahead and show you the wind shear values, the wind shear has been calming down, especially in this part of the Caribbean Sea where the AOI has been tagged, and it is forecast to weaken in this part of this Caribbean Sea as time continues to go on, probably in the next several days or so, as things continue to calm down. We also are seeing better conditions in the Gulf of Mexico at this current point in time. So maybe one last hurrah for the hurricane season before all things go quiet for the winter, and then we're going to start covering other areas of the world when it comes to the tropics. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and now show you some of the computer models that have been going on. We're going to show you the European, GFS, CMC, all those, the above, as well as the NavGM and the ICON models at this current time. Here's what we have for the European, for the 0Z European at this current point in time. Basically, we're not going to be seeing really any signs of development for the next few days or so, probably for the next 4 days or so, before things start to show signs of organization and development from the European. And NHC tagged this as to be more of a long-term threat, so definitely something to pay attention to in the long term. But however, my advice is do not panic just yet. We're going to get you more information as time continues to go on. We love information here on the Pat's Path Predictor channel, and we'll give you that as that comes to us, as well as my tropical team on Storms United. We're all on high alert when it comes to this stuff. And in the meantime, this thing is showing signs of potentially some development according to the European model. However, it is forecasted to be making landfall near Nicaragua. And then from there, it's a bit obscure as to what's going to be going on afterward, primarily due to the long-term track of the European at this current point in time. Here's the GFS model, the 12Z GFS. We're going to go ahead and show you what's been going on with that. GFS is showing signs of development starting in the next 4 days or so as a low-pressure system starts to really come through the Lesser Antilles and maybe bring some rainfall to Puerto Rico and the Dominican Republic before turning further to the south and then showing signs of organization and development before making a close pass to the Central America as a strong tropical storm or weak hurricane. And then it starts to turn to the east towards Cuba and then potentially towards Florida, where some areas down, especially around Miami-Dade County, could see some impacts according to the GFS. Keep this in mind, though. This is about 9 days out by the time this situation plays out. So nothing is nearly close to set in stone just yet. We're just giving you the possible scenarios as to what may happen at this current point in time. So that's what we have going on with the GFS model. Next thing we're showing you is the Canadian model, or the CMC, as I like to say it. And it's kind of titled this on the Tropical Tidbits website. Now, here's the CMC model right here. So the CMC is showing something similar, not really showing that much development until the next few days or so. And based because this is such a new threat, the CMC is having issues kind of really tacking this in the short term. But in the long term, the CMC is showing some signs of development in the Caribbean Sea. But I can guarantee you it's definitely there as we continue to look into the long-term threats. Next model we're showing you is the ICON model. ICON's been pretty interesting, to say at the very least. The ICON is showing signs of organization and development after the storm impacts the Hispaniola region, and then it starts to show signs of organization and development as it approaches Central America. And then from there, we're not 100% certain as to what's going to happen according to the ICON at this current point in time, but the conditions absolutely are there for some good intensification. The last model we're going to go ahead and show you is the NAVGEM model. The NAVGEM has been showing signs of organization and development starting about 4 days from now as it starts to approach Central America. And from there on out, we'll have to see how this whole thing plays out. But what we do know is that hurricane season is not over until it's over, and we have the NHC saying so at this current point in time. We have a lot of stuff that we need to continue to cover here on the Pat's Path Predictor channel, and we'll continue to update you as more information continues to come in. But with that being said, we're going to close the video out right here. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. It helps us out, helps us make more videos like these. The goal of this channel is to get more people engaged with weather. But with that being said, have a wonderful day, guys. Stay safe.